How can we make best use of technology to help our students learn? Well, to answer this question, it's important to think first about learning and only then ask how can technologies help. To make this a bit easier, I developed the conversational framework from the literature on how students learn. And this proposes six basic types of learning that we use in all our courses, whether conventional, online, or blended. So our next question is, how can we interpret the six types of learning in relation to different kinds of technology? Well, here students are listening to a lecture, the traditional way of learning through acquisition. Technology could add other ways. They could watch video case studies or listen to podcasts and do this outside of class time, and that might free up valuable time for discussion. There are different ways of learning through discussion. Students can answer questions in the whole class or discuss them together in small groups. And these are important because each student then asks and responds to questions much more than when they're in the whole class. But if small groups are difficult and you want the whole class to share their thinking, for example, then a tool like Answer Garden is ideal. It automatically creates a word cloud from students' responses where each student adds their own contribution and immediately gets feedback by seeing how that compares to what everyone else thinks. Or you could use a tool like Tricider that encourages students to add arguments for or against a topic and vote for the best response. Digital tools have the advantage of showing everyone's answers easily to the whole class, and the tutor can bring them up on the screen. So digital technology could be mixed in with quite conventional teaching methods. Learning through investigation, or learning through inquiry, is what students have always done when they have to do a project and use books to find the information. But as long as they have Wi-Fi, then they can access more information than ever, either individually or in small groups where the inquiry is propelled by their discussion. There are plenty of tools for this, like Scoop.it, Pearl Trees, or Pinterest, that help students curate what they've found. Get your students using referencing tools like Mendeley or RefMe to organize their sources as they research, and then they can share their reference lists with each other and so build their personal bibliographies. Learning through practice is one of the most powerful ways in which technology can enhance learning. Because it's interactive, it responds to their actions. And here's an example from medicine, SimMan. Is a simulated, responsive patient, so medical students can practice their approach in a controlled environment. This is intrinsic feedback, which means students can see the result of their action. Of course, technology can also provide extrinsic feedback, which is telling them whether they're right or wrong in the form of a Moodle quiz, for example. Learning through collaboration is different from learning through discussion. If students talk to each other about a topic, it makes them think and sometimes argue and challenge each other. But when they produce something together, like a picture or diagram, a piece of writing, video, then they have to agree about what it is. And that's a much more challenging task. So learning through collaboration can be a good way to get students to think more carefully about how to express what they've learned. And there are lots of tools that support collaboration and sharing of outputs, like wikis, mind mapping, or Padlet, a virtual pinboard. Learning through production means making something that shows what you've learned. And digital technology and social media have created many more ways to do this. Making digital videos, using screencasting tools, building websites or e-portfolios, or writing blogs. So while students may be learning well through acquisition or discussion or collaboration and so on, at some point they must be ready to demonstrate this to others, especially the tutor, by learning through production. So conventional methods certainly have good ways of supporting all these types of learning, but now we're discovering all the good ways in which technology can do even more.